This is the prophet Isaiah.
The prophet Isaiah predicted the birth of a Savior in the town of Bethlehem.
The fourth Advent candle is an angel's candle.
Angels are the faithful announcers in the Christmas story. An angel told Mary and Joseph of the coming of Emmanuel, and even told them to name the baby Jesus.
Angels showed up before the shepherds at Bethlehem and told them where to go and what to expect.
Let us pray. Eternal God,
he was an Indian. Well, the people that were here, and they've been here for thousands of years before Columbus, the people that were here didn't speak his language. They didn't speak the language of anybody that came from Europe. And so, as 150 years went by of discovery of what America was, there were some people that came from France, missionaries, that wanted to tell the Hurons, who lived up north of Lake Ontario in the woods of Canada, they wanted to tell the Hurons the Christian story, the story of Christmas. Now, if you do that, you've got to have God sending angels to shepherds who were with flocks of sheep, to a stable where there was a manger. All of these things we know, right? All of these are part of the Christmas story. But the Indians that lived in Canada didn't have any idea of what a sheep was. The Indians that lived in this part of Canada had never seen a sheep or a flock of sheep. They had never seen an angel, but neither had anybody else. So they could tell them about that pretty well. They had a tough time trying to tell them about things that they'd never seen. And so they started trying to find things that the Indians did know. The Indians said, what are sheep? Well, what's a shepherd? A shepherd takes care of the sheep. The shepherd tells the sheep where the green grass is and where the water is and watches over them so that the wild animals don't get them. Then they said, the Indians, you have flocks, you have herds of deer, you have caribou, you have elk. And so you're shepherds. And they said, no, we're not. We don't watch those caribou and elk and find the grass. They find it for themselves. We don't protect them from the wolves. They have to do that themselves. But when we want food and clothing, we go out, and if we do it right, the caribou or the deer or the elk lets us have them. We don't have to do anything about it except go out and get them and do it in the right process. And so there was no way that they could get it. They said, well, when did this happen? When did God send his son? You know what the date is, don't you? What? December 25th is what we say it is, right? That's easy. They didn't have any month of December. They didn't have any months at all. We've been through the same day they did, though. I bet some of you know how the Indians told what the season was. What did they use? Have you ever heard that the Indians talk about long, long ago, many moons ago, right? We've been doing this for the last 4 weeks. Today is the last day. We've been looking for this candle all month, haven't we? When the first candle was lit, do you know what the moon was? The moon was blacked out. You couldn't see a moon. It was called the new moon. When the second candle was lit, it was a little fingernail up in the sky. When the third candle was lit, it was a half moon. Did anybody see the moon last night or the night before last? What was it? What? No, it was a full moon. You didn't see it because you couldn't miss it. If you got up this morning at 7 o'clock, you could still see the moon over in there, and it was a full moon. It's the first moon of winter. Did you know today was the first day of winter? Winter doesn't come just because it snows. It comes at a special time. Today is the first day. And this morning at 3 o'clock, that moon was as big as it's going to get. It was a full moon. It's the first moon of winter. The song we're going to sing tries to talk about the shepherds, the wise men, and everything else. It talks about God. And they say, God sent his son. And they said, who is God? And they said, he's the creator. He did the whole earth, all the animals, you, me, everybody, everything. Oh, they said, we know God. He's the great spirit. We call him Gitche-Humi. That's a strange sounding word to us, isn't it? Gitche-Humi. The great spirit is God. And so they knew it. And the first line of the song we're going to sing for you is, 'twas in the moon of wintertime. That's when this thing happened. When all the birds had fled. The birds had gone south. We've seen them go. Hummingbirds left in September, and the robins left in October, and the ducks in the east have been kind of confused, but they've been going back and forth and down south for the whole last month. And the snowbirds leave just about any time. Well, we're going to do this song for you. Listen to some of the words. 'Twas in the moon of wintertime when all the birds had fled, that mighty Gitche Manitou sent angel choirs instead. What's an angel choir? Well, they're bright. They're so bright that when they sing up in the heavens, they're so bright that you can't even see the stars. They kind of dim out. Before their light, the stars grew dim, and wandering hunters heard the hymn. Jesus, your King is born. Jesus is born in Excelsis Gloria. Now, that language wasn't Indian or English or anything else. It was the language of the church. In Excelsis, in the highest glory. Within a lodge of broken bark, the Indians lived in a longhouse. They took bark from trees to make. Not a stable. They didn't have any manger. They didn't feed their deer or anything else. Within a lodge of broken bark, the tender babe was found, a ragged robe of rabbit skin, and wrapped his beauty. Rabbit skin is better than swaddling clothes, but it's softer. It's nice. We're going to sing this song for you. Listen for the chiefs from far. They were the wise men. They were chiefs. As the hunter braves drew nigh, the angel song grew louder than ever. Thank you.